I've had a chronic illness. I do things like visualization and taking action towards perfect health. I believe in mind and spirit over matter. Why is my body so slow to change? I love this question. I've had a chronic illness. I do things like visualization and taking action towards perfect health. I believe in mind and spirit over matter. Why is my body so slow to change? Just know that this is always a perfect path, that it's our alignment with our divinity that allows for us to go speedy or a little bit slower. Sometimes fear can be intertwined with our capacity to connect with the divine, and oftentimes, you know, a full out overnight release of pain or problems or illness, a chronic illness, would be too scary. And the divine won't do what scares us, won't promote even us to take action towards what scares us. So chronic illness means a chronic thought, which makes a chronic belief. So if you have a chronic illness, you've identified with that illness most likely to a large degree. You've maybe even adapted things in your life. I was recently experiencing an event with someone who had a neck injury, spine injury, and became paralyzed. They told him he wouldn't be able to move. First thing that he was able to move, though, was a finger when he was in the hospital still. So that's all he focused on. It's all he focused on was his finger moving. Didn't focus on the rest of his body not being able to move. By the time I met him, he was walking again with a crutch, but he said he would not get the little thing for your car, the handicap sticker for his car, because he said he would not let himself be labeled handicapped. Here's someone who was paralyzed and now walking with one foot that's being able to walk, but the other one's dragging behind a little bit. I watched him move into a space where through meditation, he was literally looking like he didn't have a problem anymore at all. Came out of meditation and was able to then have a little bit more movement than before, which is all he ever focuses on, is the progress and what it is that is no longer a chronic condition. His chronic mindset is perfect health. He stays on that and lets himself stay focused on that relentlessly no matter what. If you talk to him, he would say, you know, it isn't that he doesn't have bad days now and then, but when he does, he'll be kind to himself, he'll relax, he'll take a nap, he'll go meditate, he'll eat some good food, he'll do things that we mentioned during the 9 ways to connect to your bliss body, so that he can then begin again in his chronic orientation of seeing himself completely healed. I've known many people who've overcome various illnesses that people don't even know how to explain how this has happened. And it's because their newly adopted chronic mindset is to focus relentlessly on what it is they want and ignore what they don't want. And always generalize it if it starts to be hard, if you're having a hard day. Let yourself say, you know, I'm going to take it easy on myself. I must be a little tired, but boy, I can just see myself after a little bit of rest moving into the tomorrow, and I know it's going to be sunny, and I know, and start to focus on the little things that are general that get you back into the mindset that it's easier to grab onto and move with a thought that's more chronically aligned with bliss and joy and healing and health. We can do and be and have anything. I absolutely, with all my heart, believe that and know that and have seen that in action and lived in people's daily lives. We get sidetracked so much and we forget how important we are. When you see yourself as a vehicle of the divine that came here, holy child of God, to embody the good, the true, and the beautiful. That doesn't mean like the little girl in the wheelchair that I saw. She was beautiful, exquisite, and she knew it. She knew it. She pushed that yes when I, in my mind, was saying, do you know how beautiful you are? If you know how beautiful you are, then you're going to move in the trajectory that's most aligned with your divine self, that brings you to the utmost state of alignment. Hold steadfast to the fact that miracles are true. All of our divine bliss body supersedes the physical world. But again, it's from this point forward. So be patient and kind. When you say, why is my body so slow to change? Just know that there's a gap then sometimes between, if you've had chronic illness, sometimes there's a gap between undeniable 100% profound belief and feeling tangibly touching, tasting it, and where you might be now. Just allow yourself to visualize with perfect freedom and a perfect free heart what it is that you want to see and experience. And truly let yourself also steer clear of naysayers. This is a time in your life where you really want to, from the inside out, cherish yourself and let yourself fill up fully, completely and entirely with these thoughts of optimism, and not be influenced by other people who are naysayers or who have to see it to believe it. This territory is believe it to see it. And it's a different orientation entirely. You want to be really taking care of this best friend in a way that you're treating it like the best friend it deserves to be, and keeping out the naysayers or people who might be well-intentioned by making you be a realist. Look, reality is just what was created from the past up until now. That's all it is. If you want to focus on reality that doesn't feel good, have at it, but that's not the best way to live a happy, blissful life. If you want to focus on a new reality that you're creating from this moment forward, make it as blissful as possible. Be so out of the box and in a place that you incrementally get there if it's massively miraculous, or get yourself to believe it in ways that surprise and delight you, and just let yourself relax as to how that's going to happen. Let the divine show you synchronicities and ways to get you there exponentially more quickly. So I say, be kind to yourself. Why is your body so slow to change? This is a timeless endeavor. Just be kind to yourself and let yourself know that there must be a little bit of residual doubt. Let yourself just relax with that. Embrace yourself in that space of doubt. Say that's just natural when you're looking at the outside world and thinking about that coming in. Instead, you're reorienting yourself towards connectivity to the divine and living that from the inside out. So be kind to yourself and know that this is a timeless endeavor.